Everyone, welcome. We're going to solve this problem together. But first, you might want to get some graph paper. You might want to get a ruler and sketch this thing out. Set it up. And then, after you're done pausing the video, work with me because I'm going to scroll down and show you what the question is so we can work this out. All right, let's start by reading the question. Figure X and Y are shown in the coordinate grid below. I don't know why this check mark is here. Sorry about that. That's just, I think, an anomaly. And I notice we've got X, we've got Y. I do notice a couple of things right away, even before I really know what the question is. I notice, this long side is still on the left side of Y. It's the same corresponding spot. And from there, it looks like each side length is still in the corresponding position. So the first thing I'm thinking is, okay, we're probably looking at a transformation, which is some kind of either rotation, dilation, or reflection of the shape. And what we're looking at here is probably a translation, which is a sliding of a shape. I say that because the orientation of the shape is the same. So I'm thinking we're sliding the shape somehow to get from X to Y. Now let's look at the question. Let's see what they're asking us. Which statement about figures X and Y must be true? A series of translations will transform figure X to figure Y. Well, boom, there it is. And the figures will be congruent. Right? What's going on here? Well, translations essentially slide a shape over. And the easy way to think about the sliding is to draw points at all the meetings of the sides, the vertices, I think. I say vertices, I'm not sure if it's plural or not, but each vertex, let's follow it, let's see what happens. It goes down 5, down 5, right? And then up 5 on the x-axis. So we have a translation of that point, and if we follow another point, we can do that with all of them, we'll see that they each go down, let's see if this is true, a corresponding amount. So this point, right, went down 5 and to the right 5. And that brings with it every other point, down 5 and then over 5, right? So each of these points are translated, down 5 and then to the right 5. So this is a translation. Translation means a sliding of a shape. And their figures are congruent. That means they're essentially the exact same size with no differences except their location. So that's the answer. Let's look at the other ones. So a clockwise rotation will transform. Okay, so we can tell this is not a 180-degree rotation because if it was, right, think about it intuitively, this shape would essentially turn. Oops. As we rotate around the origin, that's the point here, what it would essentially look like is the same shape but in the other direction, right? That's my sketch of it. Right, so it would be in the other direction. And here says a series of translations will transform the figure, but they will not be congruent. It's not possible, right? If you're taking a shape and just sliding it around, it's going to be congruent to itself. And again, the clockwise rotation in D, we know it's not that because the orientation of the shape is the same. All right, I hope this helped.